Okay, are you ready? Okay, we're gonna make a ramp. We're gonna make a marble ramp together. We're gonna make this.
It's really exciting for developers to work on the teaching of English, and if I were going to give them advice, I would say think for a moment about what language is. Is language just structure and form, or is it also a social practice? Okay. The way that language is acquired is by actually being spoken to in that language by those people around you. So when we're teaching children, we typically try to put them in a context. We actually want them to know, be able to anticipate, to guess intelligently what we're likely to do with language. And when we talk, we're actually doing things. We're carrying out actions by means of speech.
That's that one. Perfect.
Rather than trying to use the interaction to review vocabulary to have the child repeat, she will talk naturally on things that are really of interest to both of them and that she wants the child to focus on.
Tell me, are these the same or are they different?
This small one is the same.
This, yeah, that's smaller and this is a bigger one, right?
Once you've been saying, look at the marble, we're putting the marble here, look at the cube is here, and you do a lot of conversation talking about this, and you say, is this a cube or is this a marble? And the kid would immediately say, this is a cube, right? You've been using the words enough, I don't need a word list, right? Meaning becomes transparent because of the interaction and the objects that you're handling. And you see that most of the apps that are out there only focus on structure and form, so I would do something that would get some level of interaction, in which someone could use this app to participate in a meaningful interaction.
Hey! It did it!
This is very exciting. I think we can now do things with technology that we couldn't do before.
Okay, now watch. Let's see what happens.